Hello from Slovenia and welcome to my lovely mess, because I am still playing with this different mixtures, and today I am playing with my Boessner acrylic binder for my base coat. And I did some I tried some little ones, and you see, I think that it will be okay. So that's why I will try on this bigger one. So I will start with turquoise. I mix this turquoise with satin varnish. And next I will add this gold. And dioxide in purple. Oops. I should be more careful when I'm adding this, and some gold again. I didn't mix a lot of these paints because I didn't know if this will work or not. And this one is this binder mixed with Pearlex pigment, Flex Violet, I think, and some white. And if this will work, I will tell you more about it. So now I will blow. And what I discovered, that when you blow, you have to blow for a while in this white area and then blow it out, because otherwise you will have too much white. I still have too much white. I will try this on my spinner too, so. But first I just want to see how this will work, if it will work at all. I think that the hardest part is blowing. And trying not to get too much white in the middle. And I didn't do this okay. I can already see that, so I will go once more, just a second. I don't know how this will work because this binder dries clear, so really don't know. Or just that. More. This binder is not expensive, so not expensive. Everything is expensive, but not as much as some other things, so. Start with turquoise again, and this time I will add dioxazine next to turquoise. And then gold. And then this Perlex Reflex Violet on top. And of course white. A little less than the last time. and I still have too much white, you see. I have to figure out how to do this without this big white weird thing in the middle. See all my paint from underneath coming through. So, but I just want to show you what I mean with this. And because this binder dries clear, this will all showed up. And when this will dry, so I'm just curious how this will look because of this background noise. I will still have to work with this center to blow this the way that this will not be. It's weird, as weird as it is now. So see, this paint really flows slowly because it's this binder is really, really thick. If you hear the noise, this is my oven because I'm doing a lasagna. I just can't get this composition right. will obviously not be a bloom, but we will see how this will. If the lacing will stay, if we stretch this. I just want to go over the edge here. It's a long process to stretch this out because of the thickness. And you see now my white center is not as white. So maybe the key is to stretch this enough. And then you will not have this white blob in the middle. See? It's almost gone. It's not a nice center, but my white is gone. Just don't know if I should just leave this. Because more I stretch, more I lose my composition. It's gone all ziggy-zaggy. So, I think that if I try this on the spinner, it should be okay. I will leave this now because, oops, it's all slippery. And the lacing stayed. My white is not here anymore, so I'm happy with it. And definitely this binder for background works nice. You see? I just didn't stretch it okay, but otherwise this could be a recipe for a good bloom technique. So this is it, and I'm looking forward for the next one. I just have glare again with this binder as a background. I just love this. So this was a long one ago again, and see you on the next one. Bye.